Since he was hatched from an egg, you have no idea who the mother is. Although you seem to think it's Mrs. Gappa, who of course is married to Mr. Gappa. So we've done a maternity test to determine if Mrs. Gappa is indeed the mother of your child.
No.
All right. We have the results of the maternity test, and Mrs. Gappa, they show that you are not the mother.
Believe it or not, CBS did not originally want Rod Serling to be the host and narrator of The Twilight Zone.
Huh?
Well, they originally wanted the host to be Orson Welles.
Am I wrong, or did it just get fatter in here?
But when he told them how much money he wanted, they decided to break their budget, so they eventually let Rod do it. And it's a good thing that the network didn't have their say on everything. Otherwise, some of the Twilight Zone stories we all know might have been changed for the worse.
I'm the last man in the world. But now I can drink all the wine there is. It's all mine. It's all mine. Oh, no. Oh, no. I broke my glasses.
Not very effective, was it? Or even worse.
You can't go with the aliens. Their book, To Serve Man, it's a tennis instruction manual for hippies.
To Serve Man, Brian, cool, yeah.
We're the ones you need to call. You got paranormal stuff happening, right?
Who are you guys?
We're the ghost fishers. We troll around to check for ghosts.
Yeah, we hunt ghosts by day, and we're Roto-Rooter guys at night.
Well, why'd you come here?
We heard you sing, and I thought there was something wrong with your pipes. No, seriously, we're part of this group, Supernatural and Paranormal Specialists. In other words, we're saps.
Yeah, you are.
And we try to tell if your ghosts are for real, or we debunk them.
Oh, you get them out of bed, and... Oh, is that one of those EMF meters that detects ghosts?
No, this is my GPS. I've been trying to get a signal all day.
Now, we need to investigate things here.
Oh, yes!
Did you hear that?
It's a sound effect. We use it all the time here. Come on.
Do you have any problems with poltergeists?
No, we never had that movie. I tried.
No, he means mischievous ghosts who maybe move things or take things.
Oh, well, last night I went to sleep and I had my watch right next to me. And when I woke up...
Was the watch gone?
No, but it was going. Tick, 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 tick.
Is your GPS working yet?
No, but any place is better than here.
Let's go.
Wait, I didn't tell you about my ghost riders. How about ghost motors? Maybe ghost toasties?
All right, show's over, folks.
Oh, that's too bad. I was hoping to get in on the excitement.
Well, we hope we provided enough entertainment for you tonight with the shorter movie, and we appreciate your tolerating how we broke the movie into segments so it fit our format.
Wreck you, wreck you, wreck you.
Yes, we scored high with our canine viewers, and viewers of all types will want to tune us in next time. When you know, I get a little tired of people interrupting me every time I'm trying to wind up the show, but I'm going to take care of that right now. Oh, Watch this. I'm gonna answer the door. Yeah. That better be a good reason to interrupt me here with the story.
Gosh, man. I'm so tired.
Well, why is that?
Well, I was driving to a regional meeting in my company, and I've been driving all night till morning, and I could hardly keep my eyes open, so I figured the smart thing to do would be to just pull over and take a little nap in my car.
That's a good idea.
So I pull over in a nice subdivision, and I'm finally starting to doze off when some gal jogging by raps on my car window. She asked me, "Can you tell me what time it is?" So I told her, and then tried to settle down again for a quick 40 winks, and it took a while to finally fall asleep again. Until I heard somebody rapping at my window again. It's some other jogger. And this guy asked me, "Do you know what time it is?" Well, I told him, but that was it. I took a piece of paper out of my briefcase and I wrote up a sign that said, "I don't know what time it is." And I stuck that on my car window. And then finally, I managed to fall deeply into slumber. Until some guy started rapping on my window.
Oh.
I rolled down my window and I screamed, "What is it?" And he said, "I just wanted to tell you, it's 9:15.
Movie and several great chickens. Some not so good.